Hello and welcome to Walk the Talk. I'm Shekhar Gupta in Colombo's Presidential Palace and my guest once again, President Mahinda Rajapakse. Welcome to Walk the Talk and very different circumstances from our last conversation.
Right. Yes, because when you came last time, I think it was about two years.
Less than 1.5 years ago.
Less than one.
I will tell you why I say 1.5 years.
Yes. Then, of course, we were not a united unitary country. Now it is, because earlier when you came last time, north was north and east, I think.
Right.
Was controlled by LTT, terrorist. Now we are free of terrorism.
You said you are a unitary country, but a federal unitary country, I hope. Because last time, in fact, when we had a conversation, you said that in 1.5 years, there will be peace and there will be no LTT.
Yes.
I said 1.5 years, I reminded you, because it's still 2 months to 1.5 years.
Yes.
That situation has come about faster than you even had imagined.
That's right, yes. Because of our armed forces were so committed for the fun.
Tell us a little bit about the final phases of the battle. How did it progress? What happened? When did the breakthrough come?
No, from the time after we walked into Madu, that is the northwest of the
island,
we were stuck there for about 8 to 9 months. Then it was just a walkover, you'd say.
Hmm.
But we knew after we went to Kilinochi, I mean, we were now through.
What is the biggest mistake that Prabhakaran made in this?
to kill Rajiv Gandhi.
To kill Rajiv Gandhi?
That's why. Because they antagonized the whole sympathy of India.
Hmm.
That was the biggest mistake, I think, he did at that time.
That's the biggest mistake he did in 30 years?
30 years.
Yes.
And the second was that he didn't gauge the powers of the South.
To my mind, there's a third mistake also.
Yeah.
I think, and maybe all mistakes come from one mindset, which is hubris, which is a big ego. You know, no guerrilla fighter should try to take on a whole country's armed forces in a frontal battle.
Right.
Or to hold cities or territory.
That's right. And that was another mistake that he did there.
So elaborate.
Because he wanted not only an area, he wanted the whole country.
Or not just the Tamil region.
No. His plan was to take over the country.
How could he have done that?
This
country is 85% Sinhala.
Yeah, but he didn't mind it. He thought that everybody can be controlled by terrorism with a gun.
And the threat of assassination.
Yes.
So let's elaborate a little bit more. I'm fascinated by you saying that the biggest mistake he made in his 30 years, 30-year career fighting, was the assassination of Rajiv Gandhi.
That's right.
And that ultimately led to his downfall?
That's true.